Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today we're simplifying algebraic expressions. When I say simplify algebraic expression, I mean we're removing the parentheses if there are any, and we're combining like terms. It's really important to remember what a like term is or what like terms are. Like terms are terms that have the same variable or variables to the same power. For instance, 3y and negative 7y, they both have a y to the first power. Negative x and negative 12x, they both have an x to the first power. Notice the coefficients, the numbers in front, can be positive or negative or both the same. That's not important. It's about the variable and the power. Here, kind of written too small probably, is 2x squared y and 7x squared y. Those are like terms because they both have x to the second power and y to the first power. So you can have more than one variable, you can have different powers, but they have to match exactly if they are like terms. So let's look at an example of simplifying algebraic expressions. In this first one, we don't have any parentheses to get rid of. We're just combining. We want to verify, are they like terms? Well, they both have n to the first power, so yes, they are. And so what we do when we combine like terms is we just look at the number or the coefficient that's in front here. And so I have negative 5 and positive 4. I have more negatives by 1, so my answer is going to be negative 1n, which of course I can just write as negative n. I don't need to show that negative 1. That's not necessary. What about in this second example? I have three terms. This is the only term that has a y. So there is no term that's a like term to this. So that's just going to be 4y. And it's going to have the sign of whatever's in front of it, which is a plus. But these two, negative 7 and negative 3, those are like terms, right? So they're just constants. I can combine those up. I have 7 negatives and 3 more negatives for a total of 10 negatives. So that's going to be my final answer. I can't combine 4y and 10 because one has a y and one doesn't. So remember, it has to both have the same variable to the same power for us to combine those as like terms. Now in part C, this goes back to what I said, we want to remove parentheses. We didn't have to in A and B. But here we do, and when we get rid of parentheses here, we're using the distributive property. But a distributive property means we're going to take this number out front and we're going to multiply it times the first term. And then we're going to take that same number and multiply times the second term. That's what the distributive property says. So negative 2 times x is just negative 2x. And negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. Now I have a choice to write that as plus negative 2. And then, or I could just write it at, I could write it this way too. I could say negative 2x minus 2. Those mean the same thing, right? Either way is fine. Eventually, I'm going to be writing it this way because it's a shorter way. It's more efficient. Now I have plus 6x. That had nothing to do with that parentheses there, but I've gotten rid of parentheses. And now I'm going to combine like terms. What are the like terms? Well, they are the x terms here because these two have x's to the first power. So how many x's do I have? Well, I have 2 negatives and 6 positives. I have more positives by 4, so I have 4x. And I still have that negative 2, which I'm going to write this way. That means the same thing, right? I can change subtraction to addition and change the sign of the next term. Subtracting 2 is the same as adding negative 2, so either one of those is okay. Okay, so then I have 6 of them that I'd like you to try, and as always, I would really like you to pause the video and try these so you can practice and see where you're having trouble. For number 1, we are going to think of this as plus a negative 9p. Change the sign in the sign of the next term. If you don't need to think of it that way at this point, fantastic. I don't want to get rid of that eventually, but for now we're doing that. So I have 6 positives and 9 negatives. I have more negatives by 3, and that's negative 3p. These are like terms. They both have p to the first power. In number 2, all of these are like terms because they all have d to the first power. So how many do I have? Well, if I add up my positives, I have 3 here. What is this? Well, this is really 1d, right? I don't see it, but I know it's there. 3 and 1 make 4d. If I have 4 of something and I try to take 5 away, what's going to happen? I'm going to be 1 in the whole, or negative 1d. Again, you can write the negative or not. The negative 1 or not. The negative you have to write. The 1 you can write or not. I've got 4. I take 5 away. I'm in the whole by 1. You can see where it's nice to be able to do these sign numbers without a calculator, because as we get with the variables, it's nice not to have to try to, you can't put the variables into the calculator. Okay, if you want to rewrite things so that you get your like terms together, that's fine. The like terms here are 4a minus 7a, and then minus 3 plus 5. You don't have to rewrite that, but remember, when you look at that 7a, it's the sign in front of it, so that sign is important. It's a minus 7a. It's not just 7a, it's a minus 7a. That's really important to bring that sign along. If I have 4 and I take 7 away, I'm in the hole, right? Just like I was over here, I have 4, I take 7 away, I'm in the hole by 3, or negative 3a. We can do this, change the subtraction to addition, and change the sign of the following term if that helps us see it. Maybe you don't need that at this point. Over here, I have a minus 3 and a plus 5. I have more positives by 2. So I get to this. Notice that I can't combine these two things up because one of them has an a and one doesn't. They're not like terms anymore. And now when I multiply, there's no rule about having the same variable. It's just multiply. So this is actually negative 4 times 3, or negative 12 times y. That's all I have to do for that one. Here, like I did up here, to get rid of parentheses, I'm going to do that. But I have to do it twice, and it's a little tricky, because what am I distributing here? Well, when I have a minus, it's like I have a little invisible 1 there. So I'm actually distributing negative 1 to this parenthesis. So it's important to remember a minus sign out front distributes a negative 1 all the way through. But let's do this one first. First, I start with 4 times the first term, which is 2x. 4 times 2 makes 8x. And then I do 4 times the second term. 4 times 1 is 4, but I had a minus there, so I get 8x minus 4. I'm multiplying 4 times 2x and then 4 times 1. Now I'm actually multiplying negative 1 times x. That's negative 1x. I don't have to write the 1, but I could. And then negative 1 times 5 is negative 5, right? So negative 1 times 5 is negative 5. I have to distribute that negative 1 all the way through. That's a tricky one, so be careful with that. Now I want to combine my like terms. My like terms are 8x minus 1x and minus 4 and minus 5. Those are the two sets of like terms that I have. If I have 8 and I take 1 away, I have 7x's left. And now I have minus 4 and minus 5 for a total of minus 9. Hopefully you got all these right when you tried them off camera by yourself. And finally, we're going to do one more. We have to distribute. This 3y has nothing to do with this distribution thing. We have to get rid of parentheses, and so we're going to take that negative 2, not just the 2, but the whole thing, negative 2 times y, and then negative 2 times this negative 4, and it's the easiest thing to think about it. The easiest way to think about it is to realize you're multiplying with two minus signs. So I know what people say is like, I don't know how you decide whether it's a subtraction sign or a negative. It's both. They are the same symbol. They have the same rules applied to them. So even though these were subtractions, I'm going to think of those as negatives. Negative 2 and negative 4 then makes a plus 8, and then I have positive 2. Combining my y's, I have 3. I'm taking 2 away, so I have 1y. I don't need to write the 1, but it's okay if you do. And then 8 plus 2 is 10. So why don't I write them on there? Because it's just efficient to not. Just like if somebody asked you, how old is your daughter? You wouldn't say 1 times 12. You certainly could, but it wouldn't be the most efficient way. We want to be efficient in our math the same way we are.